Hey guys! Today's video is all about naloxone. We're going to talk about how Narcan, this life-saving medication that's inside here, is easily accessible to you. But more importantly, we're going to show you what's inside this kit, how to use it, and how it actually works in the body so you have an understanding as to what's going on when we use Narcan. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video. Okay, so naloxone, the generic name, so it's always with a little N, or Narcan, the brand name, has the capital N. This is an opioid antagonist, which means it will reverse the effects of opioids in the body. And so in order to understand what the antagonist does, let's take a step back and see what an opioid is and does. Now, opioids are often prescribed for pain, but we also know that they are available on the street. And so you may recognize names such as fentanyl. That's a huge one on the street. Morphine, oxycodone, hydromorphone, those are all medications we want to make sure that people are not overdosing on, because not only does it get rid of the pain, but it decreases their drive to breathe. So how does an opioid work? Every cell has particular receptors, and let's just say this is my opioid. And as it's floating along here in the blood, it recognizes that it fits in this receptor, snugs right in there, and this will change the function of the cell. Now, we have opioid receptors throughout the body. They're in the brain, in the brainstem, in the spinal cord, and even in our intestines. I mean, one of the most common side effects that people who take opioids complain about is constipation. And so when the opioids bind to those receptor sites in the intestine, they slow down motility. But it's the receptor sites in the brainstem that are actually causing us the troubles with decreased drive to breathe. Every cell has unique receptors that will alter the function of that cell. And when the opioid floating through the bloodstream happens to land and fit into that receptor, it changes the function, which in this case, if it's in the spinal cord in your peripheral nervous system, it will bind and it decreases the pain signaling up to the brain. That's awesome. But we also happen to have receptors in the brainstem, which is going to decrease breathing. And so what happens is when the receptor site comes here in the brainstem, it sends a signal to the body to slow down breathing. Now, depending on how much opioid the patient has on board and how naive they are to medications, we may or may not see this happen right away. So the question is, how does Narcan work and why would we give this to reverse an opioid? I'm going to show you. We're going to say that this colorful one is my Narcan. Consider Narcan to be like the bully in the playground, although this is a really good bully. He comes along, and Narcan has a really strong affinity for the same receptor site as our opioid receptor. And what that means is when it sees that receptor site, it wants it, and it's going to fight harder for it. So when Narcan comes into the bloodstream and it happens to come across opioid, it's going to bump it out, and it will sit in there. It takes its seat inside the receptor site, and then that signal to change the cell's function has stopped, and it will continue to go back to its normal functioning. So what does this mean for our patients? Our patients will wake up with a bang, and if they had a lot of pain, it will all come back. Let me tell you a story. Now, the first time I experienced the actual use of Narcan, I was working as an emergency room nurse in downtown Winnipeg, and we diagnosed this patient who had just come in as an opioid overdose. We're going to give Narcan to really rule in our diagnosis. At that time, only one dose of Narcan was needed to rule in or rule out. Things have definitely changed since I started nursing, and now you might give multiple doses of Narcan before you get the response I'm going to share with you. But as they're preparing the Narcan, and I actually don't recall, I don't think I gave it. I think I was just like witnessing the whole event. They gave the Narcan, and the other nurses, I think there's three of them in this bay with me, because this is a patient who's unresponsive and their respiratory drive is down, so there's a lot of us working with her. They happened to just step outside the bay, and it wasn't far. I mean, this is an emergency room. There's the bay across the hall. They're just standing right there. And I was so excited. And I remember thinking, oh my God, this is going to be so exciting. I've read about this. I can't wait to see how this works. Well,
It wasn't as awesome as I thought it would be. It was a little bit more terrifying, actually. So they gave the Narcan, stepped out, and it works quickly. Within seconds, this patient sits right up out of bed. She's cursing, she's cussing, she wants to get out of bed, she's fighting to get away. Like, she doesn't know where the hell she is, first of all. And I did the only thing that I knew of in that moment, and I jumped on top of her, and I was like holding her down, and I'm looking at my peers, and I'm like, are you coming back? Because I am like freaking out in this moment. And I remember thinking, they did not tell me that in this book. They didn't say that the patient would be angry and hostile and try to get out of their bed and that I'd have to like jump on top of them. I was not prepared for this. And so they must have obviously came back in because we had to keep her safe. But that moment of using Narcan for the first time was quite traumatic. So I share that with you because if you're in the community and you give Narcan, first of all, as I mentioned before, it used to be only one dose. And if we got a response, that validated that it was an opioid overdose, and we could rule out every other cause. So we could rule out stroke, we could rule out seizure, we could rule out hypovolemia, low blood pressure, and all sorts of other things. And if it didn't work, we would start looking at other reasons as to why this person's unresponsive. Is it a tumor? Is it electrolytes? Is it sugars? But fast forward to today's world, one dose is no longer diagnostic. And in fact, we're giving 2 and 3 and 4 doses before we even get our first response, because the drugs are so much stronger now that it's taking an awful lot more Narcan to actually have that impact. So I share that story with you because if your patient does respond, I don't want you to be freaked out, because remember, they took that medication for a reason, likely to get rid of their pain. And now we've just taken that all away from them, stripped it away, and they're waking up often in a place that they're not familiar with. They're not sure how they got there, but more importantly, all their pain is back and they are not happy. Now, that being said, I have worked with some street outreach nurses who have had very different experiences, and that sometimes the patients will wake up and say thank you and they are appreciative because they know the risks, they have their Narcan kit with them, and they also know that if utilized, this is what's going to happen. And so this particular nurse has had some amazing stories. I wish that for you, but be prepared for the crazy. So let's take a look at what's inside this kit. Now, when we first open up our kit, you're going to notice that there's 2 compartments. On one side, we've got a pair of gloves. There's also an airway device, so that should your patient be in need of resuscitation, you have your own airway here to provide rescue breathing safely. There's also your prevention kit, and it will give you instructions here on how to use everything that's in here. And it gives a little bit more information about things such as the recovery position and some alcohol swabs. On the other side, we have 3 vials. You're always given 3 doses of Narcan or naloxone. Each vial is a complete dose, and there is 0.4 milligrams per 1 mL. And in this one, we're going to give it either, well, we have the option of giving it through intravenous, intramuscular, or subcutaneous. So in the community, we're going to give it by intramuscular injection. And then you want to check the expiry date. And this one is expired. This is actually my test kit that I teach people with. Okay, so there are 3 of these. And the other thing you're going to have are your needles, of which there are 3. Now, some kits will have the nasal spray. Others may have already pre-filled auto-injectors. But if you have this kit, I want to just talk to you about how to go ahead and draw up your medication. You're going to take an alcohol swab. You want to clean the tip of this off first. I like to leave my alcohol swab on there until I'm ready. And take out your needle. I'll just move this out of the way, so we're just focusing on the needle. Okay, then you want to take off the cap, and that exposes the needle. We're going to just draw up a little bit of air. And we will insert it into the rubber stopper here. Turning it upside down to allow the fluid to come down to the bottom, and make sure your tip comes near the edge. You can see your tip inside of there. Let's see if we can get that for you. No, too hard to see. then you'll withdraw all the fluid that's in here. All right. So what's going to happen is you're going to see that there's a mix of medication and air, and we need to get rid of the air. So we want to just push it. You can see the air moving up. And then you're going to see a little bleb here. I know my medication is ready. So we'll pretend this is my patient's leg. You simply just inject it straight in and push that plunger. Okay, so just to recap that, when you draw up, you need to draw up the full 1 mL of Narcan, which is 0.4 milligrams, that's one dose. You're gonna administer it at a 90 degree angle into a large muscle, so into the shoulder or into the thigh. Now, how many doses are you gonna give? Well, if you get a response with the first one, we know it's gonna last anywhere between 15, 20 minutes initially to about an hour. And that's really dependent on how much drug is on board for the patient and how naive they are. And what we mean by that is this the first time they've taken it? Because they may have responded really strongly, or they may not have responded hardly at all. So that will also impact how quickly they recover and stay awake. Now, after that time frame, if they start to fall back asleep on you, because they likely will, it will take more than one dose, that's when you're gonna administer dose number two. Boom. Boom. Again, they're going to bolt up. They're not going to be happy with you. They'll stay awake for a while. And if they start to drift off again and become unresponsive, you give dose number three. You're given a total of three doses in the community. And hopefully by then, your EMS has arrived. Now, if you've given the first dose and there's no response, you can go ahead and give the second dose at a 2 to 3 minute interval. And then you can give the third dose at a 2 to 3 minute interval. Again, if there's no response, you will not harm anybody if you give multiple doses, because all it's doing is looking for that one receptor site and it's gonna sit in there. That's all it's gonna do. And that receptor site just restores the cell to normal function. So if the cell wasn't unhealthy, nothing will change, okay? Now in your kit, you have a total of three doses at 0.4 milligrams. So there's a total of 1.2 milligrams that you can administer. The nurse's drug guide says that if you've given 10 milligrams to a patient and they still have not responded to Narcan, then to start looking at, is this really an opioid overdose? There may be something else going on. So where should you get these kits and why should you have one? These kits are available at pharmacies free of charge. You just go in, no questions asked, and you should have one if you have any prescription narcotics in your house, because you never know what people are going to get into. The other group of people who should have this are those who are using drugs recreationally, and you don't always know what's in the medication. You don't know how balanced the mixture is. You don't know if it's laced with something else. And so this would be handy to have on you at all times if you're going to participate in recreational drugs, and let people know you have it. That way they can get it if you need support. Now, there is a caveat in terms of the medication in here does have to stay at room temperature, so you don't want to leave this in your car in the hot summer or in the freezing winter. Make sure you bring it in with you everywhere you go. So that's it for our Narcan lesson. Go over to your pharmacy and grab one. You can even have it just for an emergency that you carry with you in case you ever need to respond. Stay safe, everybody, and until next time, make it a great day.